Sono molto onorato che voi abbiate accettato questo mio invito a partecipare a questa riunione.
I did find a letter of Giuseppe Verdi written to the music committee establishing a pitch for orchestras in Italy in that year. If this is the scientific tuning, music is a universal language, so we should have the same tuning for all orchestra, and let's adopt it. Based on this letter, the Schiller Institute has launched a resolution which was endorsed by 2,000 singers, including Pavarotti, Renata Tebaldi, Piero Cappuccilli, Mirella Freni, Alfredo Kraus. I mean, the most famous singers endorsed this campaign. Who knows? Maybe the Verdi tuning will be part of the general change of society, which we all look forward to.
Most people are not aware of them, consciously. They may be affected by them, but they're not really aware of them.
The Schiller Institute took up this fight around this question of the right tuning. Giuseppe Verdi's insistence, legislation passed in Italy. There are many reasons for this. Health of the human voice, although that's an important aspect of it.
Vogliamo fare un esempio?
We have to lower the tuning, otherwise we will never have great voices again.
Every town in Italy has a street or square named after the great opera composer Giuseppe Verdi.
Verdi turned grand opera into nationalist propaganda.
Verdi, the national hero, was elected deputy in the Italian parliament.
E devo dire che quando ho trovato il 432, per me è stata una scoperta piacevole del suono, del colore, della voce e rispetto anche per lo strumento vocale.
It was amazing the difference and how much more round the music was with the Verdi tuning.
Las contraltos y los tenores están desapareciendo. Salían sangrando la gente de ópera que cantaba, ¿sabes?
La voz sufre muchísimo menos. Una ópera que puede durar dos o tres horas, al final acaban algunos sangrando.
Por eso que se decía la gran voz verdiana.